In this video, we're going to go over how to use CES Edupack to learn more about our processes that we've selected and get more data about them. So before we were using the materials universe where it has all the materials saved within the software, now we're going to be using the process universe. So the first thing we need to do is we need to select the database. We'll start out right now with just the level 2 database. We'll talk a little bit later about the differences between the level 2 and the level 3. So I've opened up the level 2 database. You can see right now I'm on the material universe. I want to switch from that and we want to switch to the process universe. So you can see here it has all the different types of processes. So we can look at just joining, you know, so again, this is things where we'd use like fasteners or gluing. Those are joining methods. We have shaping. So how do we get our material into the general shape? And then the surface treatment, remember that is, you know, things like painting or, you know, if we do some surface machining, some polishing to make the surface nice and smooth. So you can see level 2, it says it contains 106 manufacturing processes. So right now we'll be looking at we want to get more information about injection molding, like we were looking at for the Lego block example. So injection molding, this is a shaping technique, so we'll look at shaping. And so this is where we can then, over on the left, we can look at we're just browsing, so we can look at all of the different shaping methods. So injection molding is a type of molding, so we click on that. Remember, it's a thermoplastic for ABS, because we want to be able to melt it down, so we select that one. And so from here, we then click on injection molding. And so this is going to bring up the data sheet for the processing method. So you can see here for the processing method, it has a nice description of injection molding for us, how it works, what it's used for. It also has a nice little schematic that we can look at, showing how the mold and the granular polymer would work together. As we continue to scroll down, it also then is going to include the information that went into our translation for the process selection. So it has all this information built in that would be helpful if we were trying to select a processing method from the different options. So you can see we have the shape, you know, whether it's flat or a prism or solid or hollow. We also get these physical attributes like the range of the masses, the section thickness, and the tolerance, and the roughness. And so you can see here, this is just giving us information. If we didn't know which one we were selecting, it's helping us to select it. The next section is down here with economic and attributes and cost modeling. So here it doesn't know anything specific about our process. It's just allowing us to do a very coarse analysis. You know, so if we just want to know, is it cheap or expensive tooling costs? It has that sort of built in, where if we then wanted to be able to go do a simple selection, we could just choose those types of values. You can see it also has built in a cost modeling, where it's just using, remember, it doesn't know the size of the part you need. It's using some general assumptions, and it's plotted the relative cost versus batch size. So even though CES can do this for you, this is where for your projects, I don't want to see this. I want you to use the cost equation that we used in class and use that to make this plot of relative cost versus batch size. So you'll use the numbers though that we can find here and that we find via research. So where do we get these numbers? Well, as we scroll down some more, you'll see that it has these cost values for us. So remember, we needed things like our capital cost, how much does the injection molding machine cost? And so you can see here, it ranges, gives us a nice range from $32,000 to $7,400,000. $740,000. And so you can see, you know, it has that, our utilization fraction, our production rate per hour, tooling cost, and tool life. So remember, these are going to be our inputs for the cost equation. As we discussed in class, you know, it gives us a range. It doesn't know how simple or difficult, complex our geometry is. It doesn't know whether it's a big part or a small part, whether it's a hard material or a soft material that we're injection molding. And so it only knows, so that's why it can only give us a range. So what we're going to do is we're going to use just some basic reasoning or some research to sort of choose choose values. You could always take a middle value, like assume the tool life is 1 times 10 to the 5th, because it's in the middle. Or maybe you say, like I said with the Legos, that these are really small. And so I think that these are going to last for 1 times 10 to the 6th units. But these are the numbers then that we can use then as our inputs. So if you need to get these values, this is where we can find them. Then the last thing we can do is we can scroll down and we see that there's other general information about injection molding for thermoplastics, some technical notes, types of uses, things like that. So the reason I went back, I want to point out something. So you'll see here in the level 2, we get, you know, 2 categories of composite forming. For molding, we sort of get 2 categories. If we then go to level 3, well, we're going to see that there's more properties, as I was mentioning. So now we go to our process universe. And so even if I just limit it to shaping, we're up to 131 processes. So if we look over here at things like molding, you can see there's many more different types of molding than there was before. We also see, you know, if we looked at the composites, rather than having 2 categories, now I'm up to 6 different categories of composite forming. So if we have a specific processing method that we're looking for and it's not in the level 2 database, what we can do is we can then switch this database, go up to the level 3 database, and be able to find more specific information.